Welcome to Jimmy Bowen and Friends. Each week's episode features Jimmy Bowen and a special guest like David Frizzell, Carolyn Dawn Johnson, John McEwen, and more. Today's guest is Johnny Rodriguez. Now, here's Jimmy Bowen.
I'm so excited tonight. We have a gentleman that is, to me, is an icon in the country music industry. He's got a voice like no other and a style of no other. And this gentleman is just a hoot to be around. And I'm so honored that he's doing the show, took time out of his schedule. Mr. Johnny Rodriguez is here with us tonight. We're going to have a ball with Johnny R. tonight. So we're going to have a blast. You guys stick around with us. We're going to break for a little commercial. We'll be right back.
There's more Jimmy Bowen and Friends coming up right after this short break. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Welcome back, folks. I tell you what, I am so honored tonight to have this gentleman. He is an icon in the business, and what a singer, distinctive voice, and what a career this man has. If you would put your hands together and make welcome Mr. Johnny Rodriguez.
Yeah, dude. How you doing?
I've got to mention this. Before we get into the first question, but I want everybody to know, because a lot of people don't know this. You had, let me see if I get this straight. You had 45 albums, wow. 25 albums, 45 singles, 15 in the top 10, and 11 that went to number one.
Yeah. But this is the most fun I've had, Jimmy, being here with you and your gang here. Okay, all these people, they're beautiful people here.
You lying dog, but thank you.
I was going to say with my clothes on.
Well, listen, tell us a little something here. What? Tell us about your first guitar.
My first guitar?
Very first guitar.
I stole that. No, I'm just kidding. No, I got one for Easter, on Easter, when I was about 8 years old, or six, between six and eight, something like that. And, you're seven. But my sister brought me a little plastic guitar, and I'd sit around with a Davy Crockett hat and play it all day long. And that was my first guitar.
Well, there you go. Well, what happened with your first break? When did that happen?
When I got out of jail. I just gotten in trouble for stealing goats. Me and some friends of mine sat. Well, we're not really that close friends anymore. For the record. Okay. But we were just having a little barbecue, and we were broke, didn't have any money. We were starving to death. There was about 18 of us, okay? And a constable pulled up with his lights off, and I was basting it with some jelly. And he caught me red-handed, and I told everybody to run, and they did. And I didn't turn anybody in, so I went to jail. And a Texas Ranger that was nice enough, he loved country music, you know, like we all do, and he had heard me sing it at a place called Garner State Park just about 3 weeks before that, and when he realized that I'd been in jail there, I was in jail for 4.5 months, waiting to go to Huntsville for 3 to 7 years. Hmm. That's what happens when you steal goats in Texas. Don't do it. And if it hadn't been for that Texas Ranger that came down and asked the sheriff, you know, to give me a chance to go down there and try to get a job, you know, like down in Brackettville, Texas, where I worked at a movie set, and like I was driving a stagecoach, cleaning the restrooms, doing anything they needed to do, okay, $5 a day, but it beat that jail. Then Tom T. Hall and Bobby Bear came down there on Labor Day to do a show, and they heard me sing down there, and I came up here like that year. I'd just gotten out of high school, and I came up here and just thought I'd try it, you know, like, and I went to Tootsie's and hung out for a while, slipped on the roof of her place. And then Tom P. Hall heard he needed a guitar player. I called, it was just a fluke that I called at the right time. So I was here at the right time, the right place, you know, that day. I ended up getting a job with Tom T. And he took me by Mercury Records one day on the way to pick up a guitar at the airport, and told me to go in there and sing a couple of songs to a producer. His name was Roy Day. He's deceased now, but he and Jerry Kennedy were over at Mercury Records. And I was in the middle of the second song, and he said, "Stop right there." Because I said, I thought, oh man, I might as well ruin it. But he said, "I'll sign you right now. I want to sign you to the contract." And here I am.
There you are. Now, the first song, Riding My Thumb to Mexico. Okay. That's the one you wrote.
I wrote that on the bus, yeah.
Well, tell me what that song means to Johnny Rodriguez.
It means I had a Mexican girlfriend over in Mexico and just couldn't get to her.
You're going to do that song for us tonight, right?
Yes, sir.
You're going to do it right now, right?
I'll do it.
You guys, Mr. Johnny Rodriguez.
Do it, my man.
Thank you, sir. Thank you all.
This old highway seems so long when you're going where you've been, and a lonesome song to make you cry. I'd listen to a friend of mine 10 years ago today. I'd have a better job than what I got today. But the billboards on the highway and the brake lights on the cars made me drop out on the highway with my bag and my guitar. If she comes or if she goes, it doesn't matter anymore, 'cause I'm riding my thumb to Mexico. I'm a traveling kind of man, just need a change of atmosphere. If there's a place I haven't been at all, that's where I'll go. So I'm riding my thumb to Mexico.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Jimmy, wherever you are, in heaven.
Don't go away. Jimmy Bowen and friends will be right back. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
What'd you think of Johnny? What'd you think of Johnny? Man, I'll tell you what, that was awesome. And I said during the break, you're the only man who can deliver that song, in my opinion. That is your song. I even had to hear it twice. So anyway. All right, tell us a little about this next song. Now, you didn't write it, did you?
Okay, what's the one? Oh, no, I didn't write this one. No, I wish I had.
It went number one for you, right?
Yes, sir. I had the first number one record on it. Merle Haggard and I both actually have had a number one record on this song. And even though he's older than me, he's deceased. He's my friend, okay? But even though he was older than me, I had the first number one record on it, okay? Because we were all sitting around a motel room here in Nashville one night, me and him and the late Richard Brazil and Whitey Schaefer, Dude Owens, Dallas Frazier. There were some good songwriters in there, man. And the last song that Lefty sang that night before he went home was that one. He said, I just wrote a new song. And Merle had just gotten out of the studio. He finished his album. So I was going to go in the studio like the next week, something like that. And Lefty, he needed some fast money too. So he said, no, I think I'll let old Regis over there have it. Okay, so I ended up with the song and I went in the studio and recorded it. And I had a number one. And the exactly same week, 10 years later, exactly, Merle had the number one record on it also.
And you're going to do that right now, right?
Yes, sir.
Y'all give it up for Johnny Rodriguez. God made
all the whole wide world the same. It never get old, it grows. Losing makes me sorry. You say, honey, don't worry. Honey,
send that out to Lefty and Whitey.
We'll be back with more Jimmy Bowen and Friends in just a moment. Welcome back to Jimmy Bowen and Friends.
Well, what did you think about Johnny Rodriguez? The man still has it. I tell you what, he's such a fun individual. And I'd like to travel with him from about 20 years ago. Man, what a ride that would have been. I tell you what, he is such a great artist, and we're so thankful that he's still here and sharing his talent with the world. Thank you. Thank you, Johnny. We appreciate you so much. And we're honored to have you on the show. We're going to end our portion of this show, the song, and we hope that you enjoy it. And it was written by Les Taylor with Exile. He wrote the song, and I liked it, and we're going to try to do us a little justice with it. But thank you so much for being with us tonight, and we'll catch you guys on the next round of the next show.
Run!
two graves where the water flows. I pay my respects to my Marine and my cousin, that no good man from Tennessee.